언제였던 건지 기억나지 않아. 자꾸 내 머리가 너로 어지럽던 시작.
한두 번씩 떠오르던 생각 자꾸 늘어가서
조금 당황스러운 이 마음.
별일이 아닐 수 있다고
Hey guys, welcome back. Sorry for the connection issue. This is something out of my control. So anyway, welcome back to the lectures. We are already in week 4 today. And then, so before we start, if you are having any issues with the, if you really don't like the stream quality, if you think it's too lag, please let me know on the chat so that I can just push this class to some other time. Anyway, for this lecture, before I start, let me tell you a few notices first. And first one is, if you go on Weber now, you will see that there is actually a survey, a short survey, only 5 questions that's on Weber. So for we made this survey so that we want to know what you actually want from us. It's not like we are having big issues right now. I think so far everything is still going fine. And we are not saying that you have any some people are complaining that's not the case, but we just want to know if there's anything else that you would like us to improve. Like for example, if you think the lecture is too fast or too slow, or maybe you think the lab is too difficult to follow, you don't know what you're doing. So the only way we can find out is you do that survey. So that survey is of course optional. We are not earning any money from that, but it is for you. We made that for you. So because you see, we cannot guess what you're thinking, especially girls, because girls are the most complex thing on earth. So we cannot guess what is on your mind. The only way is you tell us. And by this Friday, we are going to compile the list of all your feedbacks, and then we'll tell you what we will do about your concerns, okay? So far, we have checked through most of the concerns is that the lab is too fast and you don't have enough example in the lecture class, so we heard you. We will know what to do. But just one thing, we hope that you understand. The thing is that now this class is actually, you have quite a number of students, you have people who are really smart, and people who are very still new to all these kind of computer networks. So we are trying to find a balance here. Okay, so I hope you understand that if you are those people who are very talented, very lucky, you are born with 99% luck, 1% of hard work, then you have to understand that there are also some people who really need more time to pick up what we are going through. So we are getting a balance. If you think the things are getting too easy for you, that's because we want everyone to understand. Okay, leave no one behind. So again, the survey is already up on Babbel. You can just go and you can do this multiple times. We will not know what you say. We do not. We will know what you say, but we do not know who might be saying that. Everything is anonymous, and you can do this multiple times. If you have multiple comments throughout this week, just go and add more comments. We are happy to fix this for you. Okay, so that is for the survey. Now another thing, if you check on Babbel, you will see a very big countdown timer. And that countdown timer is not countdown to Christmas or anything, it is to countdown for your first quiz. So we will have online quiz this Friday, and I hope you're ready. If you have been following the stream all this while, you are definitely ready. Don't worry about that, because everything that will be in the quiz is something that I have said. Now, of course, it's not something that I've said directly, but something I have said indirectly. So you have to go through the video again and think about what we have discussed, what we have learned so far, and then you'll be fine. That's the quiz. So for this quiz, it is multiple choice question, 20 questions. The time is from 9 to 12. Duration is 1 hour, meaning that you can do this quiz anytime from 9 to 12. So if you have any other class running on Friday, then you just do the quiz during your lectures hour, okay? Now, this is how it works. Once you click on the start button on Babbel, you will see a link, start button. When you click on that, you will get to the quiz, and then the timer will start to count down. I hope you can still see me. It might be a slideshow. I hope you can hear me. So, 1 hour after the timer expired, you cannot change any of the answer. You have to click on the submit button. So guys, this is important. When you finish the question, it doesn't mean that it is automatically submitted. So you have to make sure you click on the submit button, and you will get a confirmation message saying that you have already submitted. Then you can go on for your TGIF holiday. Okay, so that is for the quiz. Now, for those who are thinking, what are the scope? The scope will cover from week 1, week 2, week 3, which means lecture 1, lecture 2, and lecture 3. Okay, now, how about the lab? Do you need to study for the lab? Yes, so you need to study for lab 1, because as we had said earlier, data comm, the lab and the lecture is actually synchronized. Whatever you will be learning in the lectures are the conceptual thing, and then you go to the lab to try them out on your own. So everything is related. Okay, so again, Lecture 1, Lecture 2, Lecture 3, and your Lab 1 is the scope for your quiz coming Friday. So that is for your quiz. I hope everything is still fine. Let me check on the chat whether everything is okay. Okay, so far no complaint, but I can see the viewer is coming in and out. So I don't know, I hope this is fine for a while. And if you're okay, then any questions about the quiz, you can ask now. I'll give you 1 minute time to ask if anything that you'd like to clear up. If you're okay, then we'll go on to lecture 3. We'll finish up network addressing, and we'll go into how to configure router today. Okay. Okay, now, so there are a few comments saying that you cannot finish your lab 1. So for your lab 1, by right, by now, you should already completed the lab in your own machine. For those who cannot do so, the tutor will already allocate a PC for you, and you can use TeamViewer to connect to the PC which is in our lab right now to finish your lab 1. Now, For those who haven't done so until now, after this class, immediately send me an email so that I will call the lab officer and then they will tell you how to team viewer into the machine here. Because now, if you look at the timer, you usually have 1 or 2 days left, you know. So please, after the stream straight away, send me an email. I will tell you what to do. Okay. Yes. So like I said earlier, you can do the quiz anytime from 9 to 12. But of course, if you have some other classes, then you have to do the quiz during the lecture hour. Okay, now another good question here. One of the guy is asking, I cannot open VMware. So again, lab one, you have a lot of services and command, but you do not need to run any of the program to do your quiz. The questions will be related to the command and services, but you don't need to run those programs. You don't need to type any command, okay? Okay, fine. So I guess quiz will be, I think you'll make me proud, right, for the quiz. And if you're ready, then we'll continue with lecture 3. So I need you to open up the slides and then go to this slide on IP addressing best practice. So we'll talk a little bit about how do we choose what IP address to assign to the end host. Okay, now on these slides here, what we are trying to learn is that when you design a network, I know that the stream is buffering quite a bit, so if you miss any part of the lectures, you can always replay the lecture after the stream. Okay, I'm sorry about the connection quality. This is really out of my control, which is ironic because we are actually learning about computer network right now. So okay, now for this best practice, this is Cisco recommendation, meaning that if today we design networks, okay, we want to have everyone on the same page to assign address to machine in the same way. So for example, today I build my network, you build your network. So I can choose any IP to assign to my router. You can choose any IP. But this is confusing. So let's say today I go to your network. Then I cannot know what is your router IP because it can be any IP address within the usable range. So this best practice that you're seeing on the slides, it is used to tell everyone to follow a standard guideline. So the guideline says that the first few addresses you want to keep for server, while the last few addresses, those usable addresses, you want to keep them for routers. Okay. So for example here, this network 192.168.1.0, the last address that we can use is 1.254. So this one I want to use for router. Okay, now if I have two router, then what happened? So the second last usable IP, 192.168.1.253, will be used for the last second router. Okay, now of course, it will go on this way. So for the first address, normally we want to keep the first few, maybe first 10 for the server, because we know in the network you have DHCP server, you have DNS server, you even have your own game server, your web server. So all these IP, they cannot be changed, remember? So we want to keep the first few address for the servers. Now, what you are seeing here is actually just a recommendation. It doesn't mean that you have to follow strictly. So for example, today, if I choose to use the 192.168.1.20 for my router, do you think it will still work? Yes, definitely it is the same. Okay, but just that you are not following the standard practice. Okay, so if you go to the lab, if your tutor or maybe your tutor will, some of them, they might use some other IP for your router. That doesn't mean that it's wrong. That's okay. Just that it is not the standard way to do it. Okay. Now, next thing, go to this slide where you see there are two networks. Now, the next thing we want to learn is we want to know when we send a packet from a sender to a receiver. does the packet goes to the switch or it goes to the router? So this is my question here. Let me check the stream quality first. Okay, it should be fine. So if you can look at the slides here, my question is, hold on. Just giving some juice to my Apple Pencil again. Yeah, you guys didn't see any slides, ah? You're supposed to see slides, right? Oh, okay, okay. Now, can you see the slides? You're supposed to see a slide with two networks. Okay, good. Then we continue here. Okay, now the question is, let's say now you got this PC. So you are PC1. You send a packet to PC2. Okay, so the question is PC1 send a packet to PC2. Okay, now the question, do you think this packet will be sent to the switch and then it goes to the PC2? This is path number one. The second path is it will go from PC1 to the switch to the router. From the router, go back to the switch, go to PC2. So two paths. So take a guess. What do you think? When PC1 sends a packet to PC2, does the packet go directly from PC1 to switch to PC2 or it has to go to the router first? What do you think? Yes, very good. Number one. You're my number one. Okay, only two people say number one. That's correct. So you see, the reason is that the PC, they will do this check. We call whether they want to know the neighbor is in the same network. So every time, okay, you send a packet from a source to a destination. So the first thing the PC will do is, I want to know whether the destination is in the same LAN or it is on another LAN. That's the first thing. So how do you think he will know? He will do the end operations, get the network address of each IP, and you compare the network address. So in this example here, PC1 is having the network address 1.0. Okay, PC2 is also having 1.0. Because they are in the same LAN, the packet will go to the switch and to the destination directly. This one, no go to the router. Okay, so I will explain this one in okay, you see, how do this PC1 know that his network address is the same as PC2? Remember, in the last stream, we learned how to calculate network address. So since you already know, I'm not going to show you here. And you know that after you do the calculations, this one you will get 168.1.0. Now if you do the calculation on PC2, you will get the same thing, 1.0. So if you compare these two network addresses, they are the same. And that is how PC1 knows the destination that I want to send to is in the same LAN. So again, the rule says if it is in the same LAN, you send the packet to the switch. So this is concept number one. Has to be very clear about this. Now, concept number two. If I send to someone on another LAN, then you have to send to a router, not a switch. So in this case, if PC1 sent to PC3, do you think this packet will go to switch directly or go to router? Has to go to router lah, somehow, okay? Now, over here, you might think that it's very easy. I know PC3 is in another network. That is because we can see the whole thing. But on PC, it's different. PC, I cannot see what you are seeing right now, you know. I cannot guess. I have to do calculation, okay? So, in this case, PC1 is the sender. PC3 is the receiver. So what PC1 do is, he will count his own network address. So after you count, you will get 192.168.1.0. Okay? And then, he will also count for PC3, the destination. So after calculation, you get 192.168.2.0/24. And then, you will compare this address. Is these two addresses same or different? Different. Different means what? Means the destination is not my neighbor. It's somewhere on the internet. So every time when a sender know that he want to go to outstation, okay, then outstation you need to go to airport already. Cannot go to bus station. Bus station you cannot go to China. Okay, if you want to go to China, have to go to airport. So go to router. Then from the router onwards, you will go to destination. Okay, for our case, that is what you need to know. You don't have to know what happened after the packet go to the internet. We will learn more when we talk about routing. So for now, two concepts that are really important. If you send a packet to a host which is in the same LAN, send to the switch. If you send to a host that is outside your LAN, send to the router. Okay? Okay, now your friend is asking why always 192.168. That is because 192.168 is the most commonly used private address range. Of course, there are many other IP, but in this subject, we don't use too many other IP because some other IP belongs to a global, or we call this a public address. Now, to be technically correct, those addresses you cannot use. You can only use 192.168.1.something or 172.something.something or 10.something.something because we have three IP address range that is used for private address. So in this datacon subject, if I use any other IP, we can use as example, but technically it is not correct. Okay, you will understand about this when you take the level 2, when you learn about global IP. Now, is default gateway same as the network address? No. Default gateway is your router address. Your router address is normally your last IP in the network, okay? Your network address is the very, very first address in the network address range. A router IP, default gateway is your router IP. A network address is the address you use to reach that network. Okay, now how PC1 know PC3 is from another network? I have just shown you. Please tell me you can see what I show you. Can, right? The way PC1 know that PC3 is in another network is by comparing the network address, which is what I have just shown you here. You take the two address, you calculate two network address for each of the PC, you compare them. If different, then it is on another network. Okay, now for your home router, is it combined DHCP server and router? Yes, we have already discussed this earlier. A home router, the one that TM give to you, is many things. It's a very complex thing. It is a router. It is also a switch. It is also your DNS server. It is also your DHCP server. Okay? Yes, you are right. You need to calculate network address, but not you. Remember, when two PC want to know whether to send to switch or router, they will calculate network address, but they count, not you. You don't have to count manually, okay? So I hope that, who is this guy? Why is he spamming here? This is the first time I find out that I can actually ban somebody on YouTube chat. Okay, so I guess if you're okay with this concept, we go on to the next one. Now this one, just a little bit of tips because thank you for staying with me even though the connection is not so good. And what we are going to discuss now is actually part of your quiz, okay? Now, if you go to the next slides, we are going to talk about this thing called a loopback address. So, from the name, you can already guess. Loopback means what? Means U-turn. Go back to yourself. Okay, so you see, you should know that every network adapter on every NIC, every NIC, there is one MAC address. We have learned about this. There is also one loopback address. And this loopback address is the same for every card on this world. Okay, so every network adapter will have 127.0.0.1. So this one is an IP address that you use to ping to yourself. So you might be thinking, why do I need a loopback? So let me give you an example. So for example, let's say today I'm trying to go to the internet. I want to go to Weber, and then cannot see the Weber web page. So most of the time, our first reaction, natural reaction is that, hey, Weber is down. Wow, Utah, why Utah server like that one? People will blame Utah first, okay? But some people, they will blame internet, like, hey, why my internet like that one? Every time also disconnect one, okay? So you see, it's always server problem. It's always the internet problem, but it is never your own problem, man. Okay, just like when we play online game. If I win in the online game, I'm the MVP. If I lose, you're my teammate now. Why every time give me this kind of teammate one? So it's never a problem. Now, in network, you cannot do that because sometimes it may be you, okay? So how can we make sure that our PC is okay? It is not us that's causing the connection problem. Then you can take this address, you ping this address, means that you ping yourself. In fact, I will show this for you. So to do so, you can just open any command prompt or terminal. For my case, it is terminal. And then you can ping 127.0.0.1. And over here, you see I actually get a reply. So this means that when I'm trying to check whether my network card is working, I get a reply. It means the network card is working properly. So if today I cannot go to the internet, it is definitely not me because I already checked myself. I am okay. Do you get it? Now, if you ping yourself, you cannot get a reply from yourself. You even yourself don't trust yourself, then it is your problem. You have to fix your network card before you blame the server or the internet. Okay? So that is the loopback address. Fine. If you are fine, then we go on to the next one. Okay, now, the last concept on network address, which is unicast, multicast, and broadcast. So this is also important because again, I'm going to say this softly. It is in your quiz, okay? So when we talk about computer network, when devices talk to each other, there are three ways they can do this, okay? So first one is, I talk from one person to another person, one-to-one, and that is called a unicast. So unicast is the most common kind of communication you will get in a computer network. And for example, today, if I go to Weber, it's between your PC to the Weber server. If today I play online game, it's my iPhone to the game server. So it's one-to-one. Most of the traffic are unicast. Now remember, every time you want to send a unicast packet, you will send it to a destination IP. Destination means the target host that you're trying to get to with any IP address in class A, B, and C. Meaning that everything that we have learned earlier until now, all the address that we have seen, 192.168 or 10.10.something or 172.something or in fact any IP like 8.8, those are used for unicast. So what it means is if I build a packet, the destination I put any of this IP from class A, class B, and class C, automatically this will be a unicast IP, unicast communication. Okay, now in some case, so more you can think of unicast like a boyfriend. So if you want to look for a boyfriend that you can trust, you should find a boyfriend that is always using unicast. So when he say I love you, he only say I love you to you. Now if you find a boyfriend that is using multicast. So when he said I love you, he's actually talking to not only you, many other girls also get I love you. That is multicast. So multicast is used if you want to send a data from one sender to many receiver, but not all receiver. So another example would be, let's say today, because you are following my stream, right? You're my follower. So I want to tell you extra tips that those followers don't follow me. Hey, just an example, please don't put this up. So in this case, I will just post the exam tips on my Instagram story. Just say, for example, and whoever who is not following me will not get to see that. So if I want to tell everyone, of course, I should post to Bible, right? But if I post only to my Instagram, then that is a multicast, and whoever that follows me will see. So in computer network, we call this as a group. So it's very prominent in the chatting application. So you see, I'm sure you are in some of the WhatsApp group, like FICT group, or maybe you are in like your friend assignment group. So all those group that you get on Messenger and that you get on maybe your, when you have a group when all your friends gather and play games, so those are multicast group. Okay, now how do you use this function? It's not as simple as you open Messenger and then you click join group or create a new group. Now in computer network, you have to send that packet to any IP which is within this range. Okay, so you see, if I want to send from this guy here, this red color one, to these three people here. Okay, so the first thing that need to happen is these three people have to join a group. So let's say I create a group, then this group is using 224.0.0.2. So let's say this is a group. The group name is like the IP address, like that one. Okay, so if I want to join, then this host number one have to be in this group. Host number two, host number three, all of them will get into this group. So when this red color host want to send a message to everyone in the group, he will build a packet like this. So this is his packet. You have a source. The source is yourself, also is the red color one. Where do you want to send to? You send to 224.0.0.2. So when a router or any network device, they get this packet, they know that I have to send to everyone which belongs to this group. So that is how you use a multicast. And if you want to know, multicast address is actually a class D. So earlier we have learned about class A, class B, and class C. That is for unicast. Now we have one more new one. Class D is for multicast. Okay, now how about broadcast? Broadcast is, as you can guess, is I want to send to everyone. So for example, I'm a fair person. I cannot just say the exam tips on my Instagram story. I have to say this to everyone that is taking this subject. So I will post the tips on Babel. That is a broadcast. So everyone who is taking this subject, you will get to know the tips. Okay? Now, so you can think of broadcast like, you know, the auntie group, the auntie WhatsApp group. Everything that you tell to the auntie group, in a few seconds, the whole Taman will know already. In fact, they are even faster than the speed of light. This is how fast they work. So those auntie group is actually something like a broadcast. Everything that you tell the auntie, the whole Taman will know, broadcast. Okay, so yeah, something like that. There are a lot of funny comments here on the chat. I don't think I want to say them here. So anyway, you can just think of broadcast like you send it to everyone. And why is this important? Okay, now, for example, I give you one example here. Let's say today you buy a new PC and then you connect this PC to a new network. So you see, every time you connect to a PC, like, you know what is the first thing that you need? IP address. Without IP address, you cannot use the network. So the first thing the PC will do is he will go and ask somebody, which is the DHCP server, can you give me an IP address? So that's the first thing every PC that joins a network will do. The problem is, just like you, today, if this is your first day, you come to Utah, right? And you have something like, where is the lab? Or where is my office? You want to find me. Who do you ask? You do not know who to ask. So you will ask anybody that you see, right? So something like this is like, you will send a message to everyone. So for a PC, when they join a network, they don't know who is a DHCP server one. The only chance they have is ask everyone, give me an IP. But luckily, only the DHCP server will reply with an IP. The other hosts who are not the DHCP server will just don't care. Okay, so that is how DHCP works actually. And this thing that the PC is doing is a broadcast, meaning that a new PC join a new network, he will send a broadcast to everyone who can give me an IP, and with luck, the DHCP server will give him one IP address. Okay, so that differentiate between unicast, multicast, and broadcast. Okay, now, if you're okay with this, you go to the next slide. I hope you can see the next slide, which is, I'm going to give you an example of what happened in terms of the network topology, because we have already learned the concept. But most of the time, let's say in the exam, you'll be getting a network. So you won't be getting like what I'm telling you, like a story. And you need to answer those questions in context of the network that you have in those questions or in the assessment. Okay, so now let's say in this case, you will see there are a few PC on this network and they are all connected to a router. So you can assume that they are in the same LAN right now. The question is, when PC1 send a packet to PC2, how do you think the packet will go? So I will highlight in red color. PC1 send a packet to PC2, it will just go like this, very easy. Go here. This is the first, because sender to receiver, PC1 is sender, PC2 is receiver. So this is the ICMP request. Now, in fact, when you ping somebody, let's say in this example, PC1 ping PC2, the formal name, the technical name that we use is called ICMP. Ping is actually the program name. It's not the real protocol name. So if you want people to feel that you're pro, then you don't say ping, you say ICMP. Okay, let me turn off this thing first. Okay, so another thing you should know is that when you ping somebody, it is when you get a reply, means that the message will go from here and then it goes back to PC1. Okay, so that is the reply, ICMP reply. Now you have to understand another thing is that ICMP or ping, it is always two-way, it's two-way traffic. Means that if you can go, then you can come back. Okay, ping is two-way. Now, I hope this is okay, right? If okay, then we go to the broadcast. Okay guys, for the broadcast, please pay attention to this because again, I will tell you softly, this is part of your quiz. And in this case, PC1 want to get an IP. So you are PC1, okay? You join a new network, you need an IP address. We know that this will be a broadcast message, but the question is, who do you think will receive the packet, okay? So now, I will draw this to you. When PC1 send a broadcast packet here, it goes to the switch. This packet will now go to all the other hosts on the network because this is a broadcast. So it will go here, it will go here, it will go here, it will go here, it will go here. Okay, so if I ask you, how many devices on this network receive the packet from PC1. The answer is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 devices. Okay? It is not 6 because one thing you should know, a broadcast message is not sent back to yourself. A broadcast message is sent to anyone within the same LAN, but you don't send it back to yourself. Clear about this? Now, the second thing, I'm going to upgrade this network a little bit, okay? And then I will ask you the same question. How many devices get a broadcast packet sent by PC1? So now I will add a new PC here. This is a new PC. And how many devices you think will receive a broadcast packet sent by PC1? The answer is, I will use purple color to show you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So still the same, 5 PC. Why not 6? That is because a broadcast packet will only travel within your own local area network. It will not go outside your network, which means that when I connect this new PC here, this new PC is in another network, is in a separate LAN. Because remember, everything that you connect to a router is a new network. So this PC is actually a new LAN. And a broadcast packet will never go from one LAN to another LAN. It stays within your own LAN. So in this example here, the number of devices that get the packet from PC1 broadcast is still 5, excluding yourself, and you will not count any device that is on another network. Okay, so that is broadcast message. So if you are clear about this, then yeah, that's all. That means we have finished up most of the concept that I think is important for you to know when it comes to network addressing. And next, we are going to get into how to configure a router. So I just want you to know that for the second part of this lecture, for those who have already go to the lab, you should already learn how to configure a Cisco router. And you might think that it is a bit similar. So that's fine. If you already know how to configure a router, it's good for you. But the point of the second half of this lecture is to train you into a pro. So of course, configure router is part of what you need to learn, a skill set that you will pick up when you learn datacom. And in fact, you need that skill to do your lab test one. But the problem is, let me tell you the real thing. When you go outside, if you are working as a network engineer, you know, network engineer is actually a very stressful job, because if today your internet is down, you won't be happy. You will keep calling, spamming TM, hey, why my internet is not working? So you see, they only have a very short amount of time for them to fix any network problem. So they are actually racing against the time. And that is what you will be feeling also in this subject. During the lab test one, you will be also racing against the time when you try to finish the test. And that is why later on, I will teach you how to be able to configure a router very quickly, so that you, when you see a problem, you know exactly what are the commands that you should type. Now, of course, you will think that I can look up for this command from the lab manual. That's okay. But if you check the lab manual, there are so many commands. Some commands are not important. Some are not relevant. So later on, I will help you to build a cheat sheet. Again, that cheat sheet, you can print it out, stick it on any door in front of your toilet. So every time you go to the toilet, you'll be staring at the command and you can remember those commands. And then you can also put that piece of paper under your pillow. So if you sleep with it, maybe you can remember them better. I heard some people say that. You can try that out. Some people, they like to share blue banana. They like to do this kind of thing. Maybe it works. Just try it out. And then, with that, you will be very good in configuring a router. And you can score better in your lab test. Okay? So now, the cheat sheet is already up on Babel. You can go there and you download the cheat sheet. You will get something like this. It is something like this. Okay, now what I want you to do is, the recommended thing is, of course, you print this thing out, or you can just maybe depending on what you need in the exam, you can just open the soft copy, but possible just print it out. Now we are going to go through a series of exercise. this week you don't have the PK file because you will be building the network on your own. Everything will start from the sketch. You will be the architect. You will be the network designer. You will be the one who do everything lah. Like some company you bow everything. So today you bow everything lah, including configuring a router. Okay. Now we will take a short 5-minute break first. When you come back, then we will do this exercise together. And by the end of this stream, I can tell you you will be slightly more pro than before this stream lah. Okay. So I'll see you back in 5 minutes, and we'll get into your lecture 4.
Kiri wajin mah.
Every day I find a light to make me shine. 조금 기다리더라도 괜찮은 건 사랑에 빠진 것 같은 느낌처럼 You take me up to the stars. Hope feeling raindrops in my head. 살며시 내려오면
Okay, guys, welcome back to the second of the stream. So this stream, actually, in lecture 4, we are going to talk about when do we need to use a router. So before we even want to start to configure router, of course, you want to know why you want to configure a router. And now I will play you a short video. I'm not sure what kind of quality we'll get. I'm really sorry about that. But anyway, after this stream, I will upload a better quality recorded video for you, hopefully. And then just play it through again. Okay, so before we start, we want to answer one very important question first is, when do you want to configure a router? Because it doesn't mean that every time you use a router, that's the best thing to do. For example, now you get a job, you need to connect two PC together. Should you use a switch or should you use a router? Okay, so now let's watch the video and then you'll understand what do I mean by this. Hey guys, so this week we are going to learn how to configure network routers, which is part of what network administrators do day to day. So it is good to know that we do not always need a router. In this example, we'll be looking at when should we use a switch and when should we be using a router. So over here, we have two PC, PC0 on the left and PC1 on the right. PC0 is currently having the IP 192.168.1.1, while PC1 is having the IP 192.168.1.2. Both of the address is having a slash 24 mask, so from here, we can tell that they are actually in the same local area network. And that's because both of them are having the same network address of 192.168.1.0/24. So now we have the choice of connecting these two PC with either a switch or a router. We're going to start by connecting them with a switch first. So once the physical network is built, we can now do a connectivity test by using PC0 to ping PC1. If the ping request is successful, this means that switch is the right device to connect two PC that are in the same LAN. So yeah, there we get it. We can see that PC0 is able to ping PC1, which means that for us to connect devices within a same local area network, we only need to connect them to a switch. Now, we are going to add PC1 into a separate LAN running on 192.168.2.0, and PC1 will be using the IP 192.168.2.2. As you can see on the diagram, PC1 is now located on a separate physical LAN from PC0, which is shown in green color. Now, we'll do a ping test to check if PC1 is still be able to ping PC0 or the other way around when they are both located in two different networks connected by a switch. So from the ping test, we can tell that PC0 can no longer ping PC1 in this current configurations. This means that a network switch does not connect two devices that are located in two different physical networks. So right now, we are going to replace this switch with a network router. For the rest of network configurations and IP setting, we will keep all the addressing the same. So we believe the only changes we have made is on the type of network devices that we are using to connect both of these devices. Now let's do a ping test from PC0 to PC1 to find out if PC0 is able to ping PC1 with these current configurations. Oh yeah, we got it. This means that when we replace a switch with a router, PC0 has successfully pinged PC1. In other words, we can tell that a router is the network device that connect two devices from two different physical networks together. there you have it. That means now by now you should know that the only time you need to use a router is you want to connect two or more hosts that are currently in different network lah. So now we'll go straight into packet tracer and then we'll configure the router. So open up a packet tracer first. I'll put my face down here. And today we are going to build everything from scratch. So we'll start fresh. There will be nothing on the packet tracer when you started. And we will do everything from buying the device, connecting the device, building the physical network, configuring the router, and make everything work. Okay, so in fact, if you look at the pipeline means the whole process of building a LAN. The first thing is you have to buy the right devices, okay? And then the second thing is you have to find the correct cables to connect all these devices together to form the physical network. And then once the physical network is running, you have to assign the correct IP address so that they can talk to each other. So that is the building a LAN pipeline. So in fact, in this stream, we are only going to configure a router. I think the quality is not really good. So if this is not clear to you, I try to zoom the text in a little bit more. Hopefully you can see what I'm showing you on the screen. So in this case, on Packet Tracer, we'll be using the router 1841. And on the top left corner here on Packet Tracer is where you see all the devices. So probably I will just hide my face for this one. Now, this is network device, these are end devices. So in this lab, we are buying 1841. So you see, first thing is there are so many different routers here. There are 1841, there are 4331. So the difference here is like when you buy iPhone, you have iPhone 11, iPhone 11 Pro, iPhone 11 Pro Max. So for router, it's also the same. We have different model. How they are different? Some router, they are faster, they have bigger memory. They can support more routing table, a bigger routing table. Some router, you have different kind of interface or the port on the back of the router where you connect the devices. So you see, depending on what you need, you will buy different router. So in today's stream, we are going to use 1841. So what I do is I click on 1841 and then I click on the workspace here. Now the other way for you to buy a device, because this is packet tracer, everything is free. You can buy anything without thinking how much your bank account has. Okay, you can just buy another one and then you just right click and then you drag, you left click and then you drag the whole thing and then you drop. So you can also drag and drop on packet tracer. Two ways to do so. So I'm going to just keep one of the router here. Okay, and then I'll zoom this in a little bit for you. Okay, now this router 0 here, this 1841 is the baseline model, meaning that just like when you buy a gaming computer, you can always add graphic card, you can always buy a better mouse, better keyboard, bigger display, add more RAM, things like that. Everything is customizable. Now for Cisco router, it's also the same. The way Cisco build router is they try to think what most people will use, okay? If you need more, like let's say Cisco 1841, it comes with two ports. You can only build two networks with 1841. But if you want to build three networks, what do? You have to buy expansion card, then you install it. Okay, so in fact, we're going to do this now. The way you add a slot is that add something. Now, is you go here, go into the router here. Under physical is where you add and remove the cards. And this is very real. Packet tracer is very real. Everything that you see here is exactly the same as a real router that you will find in the real world. Okay, so actually I have another video that shows you how to connect all these cables, but because we are running out of time, so I won't be able to play that video. You just need to know that this is the real thing. Okay, now again, it is so real that you have to turn off the power before you can add or remove any cards, because Cisco care about you. Cisco don't want you to get electrocuted, okay? And another reason is because DNB bill is very high these days, so we want to save power. Now, on the left-hand side, this is where all the cards that you can add. And what do you need to add? You have to read the questions properly. So for example, in the lab test, you will get different questions like add this card, add that card. So you cannot pick the wrong one. Based on the question requirement, you can hover your mouse here, left click, and then over here you can see all the description. Okay, now for you to choose which card to use, you have to read the description properly. So in today's stream, what I want to do is I want to add one more interface or one more card so that I can build three network on this router. Okay, now before that, let me ask you a question. Using existing router, out of the box, I open this router. How many networks do you think I can build with this router? Actually, I can only build two networks. And that is by connecting one cable here. Look at my mouse here. FA00, the first one is on FA00 here. And then there's another one on FA0110. So only 1, 2. If you want to build more than that, you need to add one more Ethernet port or Ethernet card. Now, sometimes the question can be tricky. For example, if I say I want to build a third network, then you can click on one Ethernet, this card here. You go here, left click. This is like your Lazada mailbox. You buy something from Lazada, they deliver to you. Then you click here, left click, hold this thing all the way here, you drop it. Then that's how you add a card on the router, on the back of the router. Okay, so of course you can add as many as you like because everything is free here. Now, what about if I don't want this card anymore? Then to remove this card, you again left click on the card, hold this thing and move it back to where you get the card from, and that will be removed. Then you can return to Lazada to get a refund. Okay, now let's say I'm not sure whether you have this card. Let's say you have. My question is, I want to add an Ethernet card that is the fastest you can find. So we know that Ethernet is not fast enough, right? Ethernet is only giving you 10 meg. So if you want to go higher, you have to use fast Ethernet, 100 meg, or you can go up to gigabit with the gigabit interface. And in fact, over here, I do have one, this one here. If I add this card here, then this will give me a very, very fast connection. Okay, so that is for my packet tracer. If you do not have this card, then never mind. This means that it is not supported on your model lah. That's fine. So again, remember to always turn your power back on before you can start to control or configure this router lah. Okay, so the next thing is, what if today you don't have enough money? You only can afford one card. Now, in that case, you will have an empty stock. So the recommended thing to do is always you have to cover this with a cover. Otherwise, anything can go inside. Cockroach can run inside your router. Your cat, because we know cat will fit into any shape. Cat is a shape shifter. Later on, you will find your cat inside your router. So you don't want this to happen, you will cover with a cover. Then nothing, you won't find anything weird inside your router. Otherwise, suddenly, why today my router is so heavy? Okay, so that is the physical part. Turn it on, then we are ready to go. So next, we want to configure this router. Now, before this, in the previous stream, when we learned about Bob the Builder and Alex the Hacker, we have already configured the router. In fact, we have already know how to assign IP address to a router by click the router, go to config, and then we type here. But actually, we are cheating because in the real world, router, there is no display on the router. There is no keyboard, there is no mouse. So how do you think it is possible for us to click on a router and type the IP address? It is not possible. So what we have done earlier is cheating. And today we don't want to cheat anymore, okay? So we are going to do it the real way, the way a gentleman do it. And that is by connecting a PC using a console cable to the router to do the configurations. So in fact, before I go there, I want you to know that there are two ways for you to connect to a router to configure. First is the console, second is the Ethernet connection using Telnet, which is a remote login. Now this is a very popular thing that you always get when you learn datacom, how many ways you can configure a router. The right answer is three ways. You have a console, you have the aux cable, you have the Ethernet cable with Telnet. But now these days, not many people is using aux anymore. So you can in fact say there are only two ways, console and Ethernet cable. And what I'm going to show you right now here is we'll be using a console connections to connect to a PC, because we know that a PC, you have a router, you have a keyboard, and then you have a mouse, you have a display. So in fact, that's the best thing that we can use. We don't have to buy one extra PC just to configure that router, right? So over here, you go to the end devices, bring up a PC, and you can name this PC anything, like you can name this admin or something. Okay, then you want to connect this using under the cable, look for console cable, the light blue color one with a curve, that is the console cable. Now this cable is a bit different because the two head is different. Like you take an Ethernet cable, LAN cable, both sides is the same, so either end will work. This one is different, you have to be careful. In fact, here on the router, you have to connect to the small head, console head, this one here. Okay, and then you pull to the admin PC, you connect to RS232, the big head. Later on, I show you one video, and then you know what I'm doing. In fact, let me show you the video now. Okay, so that you know exactly. I don't want you to just do this on Packet Tracer. Packet Tracer is not real. I want you to see the real thing. So now I will play you a video on what we have just done exactly, okay? This is a Cisco 1841 router. A router is just like any other computer devices, except that they are specially built to route and forward packets. Because of that, a network router have most of the component that you can find on a normal general purpose computer machine. Now let's zoom in and take a look at the architecture of a Cisco 1841 router. So here you can see that the router is actually powered by a CPU processor M860. This is a special purpose chip that Cisco designed to optimize the workflow to forward and route network packets. Now if you're asking, can we use any Intel processor to run on a Cisco router? Yes, it is possible, but we will have to rewrite the whole operating system that is running on the Cisco router to run on the Intel processor architecture. So you should also notice there is a SD RAM up to 128 megabytes that is currently built in on this router, and this is again expandable to 348 megabytes. So depending on how complex your configuration is and how many routes that you want this router to support, you have the options to scale up or scale down the memory configurations on this router just as if you would do on a common computer machine. Then you would also notice there is quite a number of slots that's built to support flash drive. And this is quite common in a Cisco router because network engineers normally carry around their network configurations on the router in a flash drive so that this is easily transferable to any other routers that they are going to configure in the future during all the networking configuration pipeline. There's also a built-in flash up to 128 megabytes of size, but most of the time you will get 32 megabytes out of the box, and this is used to store the operating system of the router. So you might be thinking, wow, I can store an entire operating system in just a 32 megabytes of storage. Well, like we said earlier, Cisco router is running on the Cisco iOS that is heavily customized and optimized, which is one of the reasons the operating system do not take up a large storage footprint. So one interesting fact here is that this iOS is totally different from the Apple iOS that's running on your iPhone or your iPad or any Apple devices. So you can actually run Facebook or Instagram on a Cisco router. The NVRAM is a place where we store all the routing configurations that we have performed on the router, and it is always important for us to save the configurations from the random access memory RAM to the NVRAM so that the next time we start up a router, we can load up our previous configurations instead of starting anew. Then you'll notice there are a few
ports that are connected using the yellow colored line, which is all the physical interface that we have on this router. In this example, we have two fast Ethernet ports, which means that we can connect two network devices to this router to get to the internet. But most of the time, we'll be connecting a switch to either these two ports. And we also have two slot zero for some other network interface card. On the top left corner, you'll notice there is an aux and console port, which is where we connect the console and aux cable for us to configure this router. So coming up, we'll be looking at how we can connect this router to a computer for us to perform some simple router configurations using the input-output device on the computer machine. So the first thing that you will notice when you're trying to configure a router is, hey, wait a minute, where's the display? And without a display, how can we know what we are configuring on the router? That is actually a design decision, a smart design decision by manufacturers, because they know that we do not need a display on a network device so often unless when we are configuring these devices, which is why for us to configure any network devices like a router and a switch, we need to connect them to a machine that's having a display. And one of the best devices that is readily available would be the PC or the laptop that you are using. Now, the next thing that we would like to find out would be all the ports that is available on this router. And specifically, we want to find out what are the ports that we should connect the PC to for us to configure this router. Looking closely at the back of the router, we see that there are fast Ethernet port in the yellow label, the console port in the light blue label, and we have slot 0 where we have the serial card attached. To the right of the router, it is a power switch for us to turn it on and off, and also the power cable that connects the router to the power supply. So now, the question is, when we want to connect this router to a PC for configurations work, what kind of cable and which port should we connect the router to? This is the console cable. The console cable allows us to connect the router to any device with a display. With that, we can start to configure the router using the input-output devices and the display on a remote machine. With the console cable, we'll connect this end of the cables to this console port on the router. That's it. Now, on the other end of the console port, where you have the slightly bigger head, this goes to the PC that's currently having a display. And the other end of the cable goes here into the machines that we are going to configure the router from. So that is how you connect your router to the PC. Okay guys, so what you have seen earlier is exactly what we are doing on Packet Tracer right now, which is using the same light blue color cable. We want to connect the PC to router to do configurations. So we are going to get back to the Packet Tracer now. And the way we connect, after you connect this cable, what you do is you go to the PC here, go back to the admin PC, go to desktop, and you want to look for terminal, okay? Not command prompt. This time you'll be using terminal to configure this router. Now, if you click terminal, you'll see there are a few values here. And all these are, we call this layer 1 value. We don't want to mess with any of this value because it is important for the device, the PC, to synchronize with the router. This one only the real engineer know what is the
value to change. Okay, so we are not real engineer, we are fake one. Fake engineer, fake doctor. So keep this everything as default, just click OK, and then you will get into a screen like this, which is exactly where we call this the CLI. And what is this? This is the command or the workspace where we type in our command for to configure routers. Okay, so when you see this screen, what it means is that we are already inside the router. We can start to configure this router as the, any way we like it to be. And if you go to this router, if you minimize this one, and then you go to this router, you left click on this router, and then you see there is this prompt called CLI, which stands for Command Line Interface. Now this thing here, you can also configure your router here. You can also type your command here. In fact, this thing and this thing, let me show you. You tell me. Do you think these two things looks very familiar? You see, whatever that I do here, let me turn this off. So I type something here. Let's say I type config T. Oh, sorry, cannot type yet. So EN. Let's say I type EN. You see, the same thing will appear here. What it means is that these two screens are exactly the same thing. Okay. So, but you should know, in the real world, this one don't exist, because like we said earlier, you cannot go to a router and type command. There is no keyboard, there's no mouse. So if you want to be real, you have to configure from the admin PC here. Okay, now because this is just packet tracer, in the exam, there are some routers that you can only configure using a PC, but there are also routers that you can configure directly using the CLI on the router itself. So for this stream, doesn't matter. You can choose. If you like dark mode, those people who like dark mode, you will use this. If you don't like, you like light mode, you'll use this. Okay. Anyway, they are the same. So we will go on to configuring the router. And for this stream, I will be configuring from here onwards. Now, before we even start to configure a router, every time you buy a new router, he will ask you. Now you don't see this here because it's not new. But a new router, they will ask you, do you want to go through the auto configurations? For you to get out, you just press the Control C button on your keyboard. Okay, in fact, why not I buy a new router and then let me show this to you. So if I get a new router here, say 1841 here, again, I will connect this console port to this RS232 and I want to configure this router using terminal. So click OK, and the first thing you will see is this. Do you want the router to do auto config? Now, don't do this, just press Control C on your keyboard and then you will get to a prompt where you see router with a right arrow sign. That means you are already in the user mode of the router. So next thing is that you should know, a router is different from a PC in terms of security level. So what it means is that on a normal PC, let's say you're using a Windows 10 PC, you only set one password. Either you set a PIN, or you use your face recognition, or you use a real password. And once you log in, you are free to do anything on your PC. You can run any program, install program, write code, things like that. Okay, even on admin mode. And that is the PC. For a router, it's different. Because a router, many people will go into a router one. For example, in a company, the manager will use the router. An intern, a new intern who just joined the company will also use the router. So you see, different people should see different things or should be able to do different things on the router. We don't want the intern, first day, join the company to be able to change the IP address of the router. And then what if the intern think, you only pay me 500, my friend get 1000, I'm not happy. Then he will mess up your router. So, which is why on a Cisco router, all routers are running on the operating system we call Cisco iOS. This iOS is different from the Apple iOS, okay? You cannot run Facebook or Instagram on this Cisco router. The naming is the same. And the different of this, this OS is different from other normal OS in a way that they have different level, okay? And different people will get to different level. For you to get to different level, you have to put in different kind of password, okay? So I will show you on the screen what are those levels and how do you get from one level to another. Now, why is this important? Is because like what I said earlier, if you are doing a command or you type a command on the wrong place or the wrong level, then you'll get an error. So you have to be very clear about what you're doing on the router, and you have to be very clear about which level that you're currently in at the moment. Okay, so why I'm showing you this is because I want you to be a pro in getting in and out the router. So you will have a screen like this. This is normally what you see. Okay, these are all the levels. So every time when you go into a new router, you will start here. This is the level one here. We call this the user mode. This is where you will land every time you get a new router. Okay, and you know you are in level one by looking at this prompt. If you look at the right arrow, then you know you are in level one. Okay, now for you to go from level one to level two, here, you will type the command EN, the shortcut, which is the short form for enable. So in level two, you want to go to level three, you will type the command configure terminal. The short for this is config T. And for you to go from level three to level four, you will type in the interface that you want to go to. So for example, INTFA00. We'll try this out later. Now, what we have done is that we have go from user mode to privilege mode to global config mode to interface mode, level 1 to level 4. Okay? Of course, sometimes you want to go back out because you want to do different things on different levels. So for you to go back out from the level 4 to level 2, you can press the Ctrl plus C button on your keyboard. This will bring you up back to level 2. Now, if you want to go all the way up, meaning that you want to exit the router completely, then you will type the command exit in the CLI. Then this will bring you out from the router. And this one, I want you to be very familiar with this, because a pro engineer is very fast. In, out, ting ting chu chu, must be very fast. Very familiar how you get from one place to another. Okay, so if you're clear about this, let's get back to your config. And now we are going to get in and out from that router. So over here, when you see this prompt, you know that right now we are in the user mode. And how do I get to level 2? I will type the enable. The long form is enable, so you always want to save time, so you type EN. Then for you to go from level 2 to level 3, type config T. For you to go from 3 to 4, type interface. INT is the short for interface, followed by the label. So on this router, remember we have two labels, right? You have, if I point at the router, you will see I have FA00 and FA01 here. So I can choose any of these. Now let's say I want to go to FA00. So what I do is I will type FA00 here for me to get to the interface, which is why it is very important for you to be clear about what interface that you are trying to configure. In the exam, you'll get so many different interfaces. If you put the IP at the wrong interface, then the whole network won't work. So you have to be very clear about where you are at that moment and what you're trying to configure for. Okay, now we are already in level 4. Let's say I want to go back out. I will just press the Ctrl C button on the keyboard, press enter. Then you see now I'm back to the privilege mode in level 2. Again, if I want to go back up even further, I will type the command exit. And this will bring me back to the user level, which is where I landed when I first connect to this router. Okay? So this is how you get in and get out. Now, if you're clear about this, we are going to start to look at your cheat sheet here. So I want you to open up your cheat sheet on any other device that you have right now. And then we'll start with this thing we call the startup routine. Okay, now, this one, what you have here, remember, this will be your new girlfriend for this semester in this subject. Keep them in your wallet. Bring them with you all the time, anywhere you go. Okay? We have a question here. Can you change the keyword? Yes, later on, I will show you how you configure password for a different level. Now, first thing, what I show you here, you can do this or you can skip some of this. Not everything is important. You can do this, or you can skip some of this. Not everything is important. The reason I show you is because it make you to be a pro, and you will save a lot of time during configurations. So, first thing is, on packet tracer, you need to make sure that you have already turned on the preference that shows the port label. Now, for example, in my case here, let's say I connect this router to a PC, okay? And remember, on packet tracer, you can always use this this two symbol. So you see, the God that we pray to many gods, right? But in computer network, we pray to Zeus. Zeus is the god of thunder, and Zeus will always help us to figure out what are the cable that I need to use, like the auto mode. So I don't have to really know about what is the right cable, what is the wrong cable, okay? So let's say I do this, but I need to know what is the interface. So first thing, again, for your exam, if this is not on yet, you make sure that this is on. So you go to preference, and then you click show port label. Once you enable this option, then you will see this. And this is very important, because in a router, you might get 10 interface or 8 interface. So if you don't turn this on, you might configure wrongly at the wrong place. Okay? So that is the first thing. As a warm-up, you should do this. And then, okay? So that is the first thing. As a warm-up, you should do this. And then is, go back to your cheat sheet here. Now, this one we have already gone through. How do you configure a router is by connecting the router to a console, a PC using a console port. Now, this one, I will come back to this later because we haven't learned about how to configure, so it's not the right time yet. And next, we want to go to all the yellow color one. Okay, so we are going to see what kind of info you want to check on this. Okay, I can see that the stream is lagging, so it's okay. We only have 15 minutes more to go. Hang in there. I'll try to cover as much as I can so that you have something to try and play with this weekend. So let's talk about the yellow color one. You can see all these things here, they are for checking. So whether you type or you don't type this command, it doesn't affect the router. You don't make any change. In some of the lab, you will learn how to type a lot of command, show clock, show user, show IP interface. Then you think that, oh, I'm a pro. Actually, you didn't do anything, you know. You just asked the router to show you something, okay? And why is all this command important? It's because when you really already did something and you do not know whether you configure correctly or not, these are all the commands that we will use to check whether the configuration is done properly. Okay, now, let's get into the router. And the first thing you want to do is, every time you're running the correct version. So for you to check, you will use this command show version. And just like you buy any new PC, I think the very first thing you do is you will check the spec. If you buy a Windows 10 PC, when you get the PC, you will check whether the seller got cheat me or not. Is this really Windows 10 or not? Okay. And then after that, you will also check. Okay, I buy Intel i7, so I want to get i7, not i5. I want to check whether I get 32 gig of RAM because I pay so much money. So all these things we will check. For a router, we also do this, okay? Because I want to know whether the router is running the correct operating system, the version of the iOS. So for you to do this, you can just type show version, and there you go, you will get to see the version. And there you go, you will get to see the versions here. So what you want to see specifically is this line here. And this line will tell you what is the current version of the image file of the operating system. And now, if I ask you this question, you can answer me very easily. This router is running on this version. The operating system is running on this version. Okay? That is show version. Now, another thing you can try is actually to show flash. When you do a show flash, it means that you want to see all the content or all the files that are currently stored on the flash on this router. So remember earlier during the video, you see that on the router there's there are just like your PC, you have CPU, you have RAM, you have all this stuff, and one of the components is flash. So flash is where I keep the operating system. For example, in our PC, I will install Windows 10 on hard disk, C drive or D drive. On the router, we will install or we will keep the operating system in the flash drive, the flash. So when you do a show flash, you will see that this is exactly the file that you see when you do a show version. So you see, you can compare. These two files is the same thing, this one and this one. In fact, they are the same thing. Okay, and that is because when you turn on the router will run this file from the flash. And you can also see another thing is that, wow, this is really, really big. So you see, it takes up half of the storage size of the flash that we have on this router. So we know that this OS is quite a big OS. Although just now we say it is not. If you compare to Windows 10, of course, it's way smaller, but it is also taking up a lot of space here. So that is slow show flash. Okay, now, another thing, the next thing I want to try is, I want to see what are all the files that are currently inside my router. So what do we have on a router? You have flash, you have RAM, you have processor, you have so many other things. So if you do a show file system, then you will see all the files that are available right now on the current router. So over here, you see that I have flash. Okay, so flash is one of the components that you have. I also have NVRAM. So from here, it is not showing you the file, that's fine, but you can already know that how big is the flash, or is this big. The RAM is like this big. Okay, so when you do a show file system, it shows you all the components that you have on the router, which means that now, today, if you decided to upgrade, you want to add more, you want to change your flash to a bigger size flash. I'm not sure whether you can really do it, but let's say you want to make it to a bigger flash, you change your flash and then you want to see whether it is detected, you do this one, then you see whether the size of the flash increase or not. So that is show flash. Okay, now let's go back to your cheat sheet here, and then the next command you want to try is, now you have many other shows, okay? If you are asking, do I need to remember this command? In fact, no, there is no need, because I'm going to show you now what we call autocomplete on the Cisco CLI. So let's say, for example, now I want to show some other thing because I cannot show you all the commands, right? Now, what if today you need a command that I didn't teach you? So what you can do is you can use the question mark sign on the keyboard. Every time you press a question mark, the CLI will show you all the available command that you can type. So it means that now, when I do a question mark, these are all the syntax or the parameter that I can show. So for me to go to next page, I will press the space bar, okay? Space bar on your keyboard, and then it will go through the whole list. Now, for example here, if I get a new router, okay? I'm in user mode. I type EN, I go to the privilege mode. Now, I don't know, what can I do on this router? So I can type question mark here. These are all the commands that you can type on the router, okay? So for example, you will see one of it is show. So I type the show command. And then, what are the next syntax? Of course, I cannot remember all the commands. So I will use question mark again. So these are all the parameters that I can type after the show command. So for example, now I want to show the time. So you can, what you can do really is very simple. You go through the list. Then you see, if I want to see the clock, then I use this command clock, display the system clock. And if I type over here, show clock, clock and enter. See, now I already see right now the current time on this router is, 1993. It's a very old router. So this is how you use the question mark. So when you are writing a very complex command, you do not have to remember the command or what comes next, what comes after. You can always type a command followed by a question mark and then keep on doing so. So for example, now I will show another example, show IP. So if I do a show IP, what is next? I press question mark again, then these are all the things that I can type. So for example, now I want to show interface, okay? So I will type show interface brief. Then put a question mark again, brief. Then I'll see all the available ports on this router, which is real. You see, when I type show IP interface brief, it shows me that on this router, currently I have fast ethernet. I can build one network here. I have fast ethernet 00 and 012. Okay, which is true because if you go back to the physical part of this router, I have one here and one here, two ethernet ports. So let's say if I turn off this router, I add one more card, which is what you have already done. I turn it back on, and then I go to this router, I type the same command. So en show IP interface brief. Now you see I will have one extra line here, which is exactly the new card that I have just added. So this command is very important. You'll be using this command most of the time when you want to see what interface you have, what is IP address on the router, whether the interface is working or not. These are the command, which means we don't want to always type this because you see, if I keep typing this one, it is wasting me a lot of time. Let's say I want to type show IP interface brief. Every time I type this, it will take me 3 seconds. If I type this command 10 times, it is already 30 seconds wasted. And it's a problem because we are racing against the time. So on packet tracer or on any Cisco command, you can use what we call autocomplete. So this is how autocomplete works. I type show, and then I can just type IP, and then I type tab. Okay, you see I type INT. I don't have to finish the whole keyword. I type the tab button on the keyboard. It will finish up the whole word for me. I type BR, and then I press on the tab button again. It will finish up for me, and then I press enter. I'll get exactly the same thing. So let me try another example here. Let's see what else we can show. We can also show like maybe there's nothing much that I can show here to really show this example. So I'll just do a config to show you. So for example, if I want to set an IP address, you don't have to follow this. This is just an advanced example. So I type IP address. Instead of typing the full thing, I press the tab button. It will complete this for me. Okay, now if I do not know what is the next thing for me to type, it will complete this for me. Okay, now if I do not know what is the next thing for me to type up, then the router will tell me this is the next thing that I'm expecting from you. So that is the autocomplete. Okay, now another thing I want to show you which is really cool is that we have these shortcuts on all the Cisco router, and let me show you how do we build shortcut. So again, I want to show the same command, show IP interface brief. But most of the time, you do not have to type the full thing. For me, if you have done this so many times, you know that I can just type SH, which is the short for show, IP, short enough, no need to be shorter. Interface, I can just type INT. Brief, I can just type BR. And you see, I'll get the same thing again. And this is the shortcut that you should be familiar with when you are configuring a router. Okay, so what does this mean is that how do I know this? Is this magic? No. Is this experience? Maybe a little bit, but there is actually a way for you to derive this shortcut. So on the CLI, you can only take the first few characters that is unique enough to identify this command. Unique enough means that there are no other commands that happen to share the same shortcut. So for example, show. If I type show, if I type SH, it is the router know you want to show. But if I type S, it is not enough because you see, if I type S, the router doesn't know do you mean send or do you mean set up or show, correct? But if I type SH, definitely you want to show because there are no other command that is using SH, only show. So this is why SH is the shortest that can go. IP. Now for interface, you see, if I do a question mark here, if I type I only, it is not enough because I can refer to this, inspect, or it could mean this. So the way we can uniquely tell the router, the short form that I'm trying to mean here is interface, I need INT at the minimum so that this one is unique enough. INT, then the router know you want to mean INT, so I just put INT. And the same go for BR. And that is how I come up with this short form to show the interface that I have on this router. So that is the CLI shortcut, okay? Now, if you're okay, then let's get back to this cheat sheet here. Now, on the cheat sheet, on the check info part, all the rest of this thing, you can try to run this. But as I say, when you run this, it doesn't really give you anything except to show you something. And of course, the most important thing is that you know what you're looking for. And I won't be going through all the show command here because it doesn't make sense yet. When we need them, we'll come back to that. Okay, but there's one show command that I want you to know, which is show run. Show run is the most important show command that you will ever use, because everything that you configure on the router today, whatever changes that you make, if you do a show run, it will show all the things that you have configured on this router on this show run command. Now, of course, if you want to check the info, always just press spacebar and then it will go, it will scroll through the info. But maybe it doesn't make sense to you yet, or if you have already done the lab, then maybe you already know what's going on, which is good. But what I want you to know now is that show run, everything that you configure will be here, which means that one day, if you have configured a router that you think you've done it right, but in the end it doesn't work, what should you do? Of course, you cannot cry, you cannot call your boyfriend or call TM. What do you want to do? You will type show run. With this, you will go through the list of the info here, and then you will find out what is wrong. And that is why show run is important, because it will show us all the configurations that we changed or made on a router. Okay, so I'll stop here. We are already at this table here in the cheat sheet. Keep this with you. So on the next stream on Wednesday, we'll continue with this, and I will show you how to configure for the rest of the router. Now, for those who rest of the router, now for those who have done the lab or who is going to do the lab, you'll find this kind of similar. That's fine. In the lab, you can just type, try to finish the lab. If you can understand, that's good. If you cannot, on the next stream, I'll explain to you each of the thing that you're typing, why you are typing that, and is there a better or a faster way to do that. Okay, so that's all for today. A word for the sponsor. Thank you for all of you, because you guys are the sponsor who are paying my salary today. Thank you for joining the stream. And really, really, I'm really sorry about the connection quality here, and hopefully next stream will be better. So until then, see you again, and good luck on your quiz. Good luck. Bye. Peace out.
Working part-time, waiting tables. Left a small town, never looked back. I was a fly.